Hi there, I'm Scott Valentine. I'd like to show you this technique for creating 3D fabric in Photoshop CS5 Extended. Now you've probably seen other 3D flag tutorials, but they rely on using displacement maps in order to get a 2D image. This version is much more flexible in that you end up with a true 3D object that you can reposition and manipulate in any way that you see fit. Let's go ahead and get started on this one right now. And I'll turn off the demo layer, create a new one. And let's just clear up the background. Now on my blank layer, I'm going to fill it with a 50% gray. This will be the foundation for our 3D object. We'll create that object by going to the 3D menu, New Mesh from Grayscale, and Plane. This will give us a simple 2D object that will be the flag that we'll end up with. I'll go ahead and reset that to its home position. And you'll notice, when we created that object, we got two free layers in the bargain. One is a diffuse layer, and one is the planar depth map. The planar depth map is where we'll work the magic to create the folds and ripples in the flag. But in order to finish this, we need to create another texture layer. So I will go to my 3D scene panel. I'll choose Filter by Materials. And down here on the lower section of the panel, I'll create a new bump texture. The new texture comes up with the default document size or whatever you've got stored on the clipboard, but I'm going to use a preset that I've created to give me a 512 by 512 texture size, so it's square, and I'm also going to use 16 bits for this. Now the default document is in 8 bits, but I want to use 16 so that I get greater fidelity between the high and low elements. So when I open up the bump layer here by double clicking on it in the layers panel, you'll see it's just a square document. I'll create a new layer above it and also fill that with 50% gray. I'll add a little bit of noise. Let's say 100%. And I'm going to use Gaussian and monochromatic. Go back to filter, noise, and use median, which will give us a crosshatch pattern in here. I'm leaving the radius set to 10 pixels and select OK. Now we want this to be a seamless texture for the bump layer, so what I'm going to have to do is a little classic texture maneuver to get rid of any seams. We'll go to Filter, Other, and Offset, and I'll choose half of the document size, which is 256 by 256, and I've got the undefined areas set to wrap around. We'll select OK, and then I'll use another new tool or another new feature in CS5 for the spot healing tool. I've got content aware selected. If I click at the top, hold down the shift key, and click at the bottom, it takes care of that seam pretty nicely. We'll do the same thing for the horizontal seam and add just a little bit more there. When it's done, I'll repeat the offset filter to get back to my original texture and look for any areas that aren't going to tile nicely. Finally, I'm going to add an attenuation layer above this. That is simply another 50% gray layer that I've reduced the opacity on. The reason for that is if I left the bumps at full scale, it would probably overwhelm the texture and not look realistic. I'll set it to 80%, save, and close the document. And if you look carefully, you'll see some of the texture is showing up right there on our plane. It's not very pronounced, but we want it subtle, so I'll leave it the way it is. Reset my object to home. And now let's add our artwork to the diffuse layer. I'll double click on it. And I'm going to place some previously made artwork. I'll just hit Enter key, and this is good to go. The art you're looking at is actually from a stock vector site called vectorart.org. This is called Dragonflower, and it's by freshmedia.com, so be sure to check them out. This is all I need to do for my diffuse layer, so I'm going to save it and close it. And you can see it's applied immediately to my flag, with a little bit of the bump texture just visible at the right angle. Now let's get into the heavy lifting. Let's open up the planar depth map. And I'm going to show you that right now we're starting off with 8 bits of depth. Later on we'll change it to 16, but 8 bits right now allows us to get full access to the filters menu. I'll duplicate the default gray layer and press D to get my default black and white foreground and background. I use Filter, Render, Fibers. I want a fairly low variance and a fairly low strength. I can randomize this a few times to find a pattern that looks good for me. I'm looking for something that has a nice distribution of light and dark areas, and this looks pretty good. We'll stick with that and click OK. I'll give it a nice blur. Let's say about 20 pixels. And now we're going to distort this using the shear filter. Now I've set up the shear filter to have this particular curve because most flags will hang from the top corner and blow partially towards the lower opposite corner. So this is a good approximation and a good way to start. I've used wraparound for the undefined areas so that we don't lose any pixels or have any odd edges. I'll select OK. I'll blur it again just a little bit with a smaller blur to get rid of those hard edges that are created. And now I'm going to reduce the size and use the Transform Warp tool to kind of pinch this upper corner. What I'm looking for is to gather up that corner so that it looks more like the fabric is hanging from that particular spot rather than just being distributed all across this edge. So we can push this up a little bit, drag out the lower corner, and just kind of get a nice fabric look to it. Let's go ahead and pull this out a little bit. And of course you can hand paint these textures as well. This is just a quick and easy way to get to some nice organic looks in the depth map. Now if I were to save this, we can go back over to the original image and you'll see that it's not quite suitable. See, it's very bumpy. So let's go refine our planar depth map just a little bit more. I'm going to add just a little bit of noise. In this case, maybe about 2%. I'll just type that in. Gaussian and monochromatic. OK. And I'll change my image mode now to 16 bits per channel. You can see a lot of our filters went away, but that's OK. I just want to use blur, Gaussian blur, and just large enough to get rid of those pixels that we've created. OK. And to smooth things out again, I'm going to fill with another 50% gray layer, lower the opacity to about 75 or 80%. There we go. We'll save it. And let's see what this has done to our 3D fabric image. There we go. That's looking pretty good. And what's really nice about this is that it's very, very flexible. Let's go ahead and set up the camera angle a little bit wider. Let's do 18 millimeters. We'll zoom in. And let's set that object a little bit more like that. There we go. And we can finish off with a gradient in the background, just to give us a little more interest. So there you have it, 3D fabric done in Photoshop CS5 Extended with very little effort and an infinite variety of configurations you can come up with. I'm Scott Valentine and I hope you've enjoyed this presentation. Thanks!